Everybody knows the best passwords come from a combination of your favorite pet and the last two digits of your birth year. For those wishing to implement this fail-safe method, there are a few ways to do it. We'll cover adding a password to a page, adding a password to a folder, adding a password to your whole project or website, and finally, designing your project's password page. Let's first start by censoring the password we plan to use here, since it's the same password Kyle uses on his Wells Fargo login, and we'll copy the password to the clipboard. Over in the Pages panel, we have a certain page we don't want accessible to everyone. Simply go into the settings for that page and enter the password. We're just pasting the password we censored before. Let's save. And if we try to access this once the site is published, we're presented with the password protection page. Note that you can use different passwords for different pages. You don't have to use the same password. But that's how to set a password on a single page. Let's password protect a folder. Same deal here. Want all the pages in a particular folder to show a password prompt? Same deal. Go into that folder settings, add a password, and that'll apply to all the pages. Let's save here again. If we try to access externally, any of those pages in that folder, access denied, unless you have the password. Now, page passwords and folder passwords can be added or modified from the editor. This means your clients or whoever collaborates on the project can go in and add or even change a password to a page or a folder from the Pages panel in the editor. That's folder password protection. Let's look at adding a password to the whole project or site. We can get to this from our project settings under General. If we scroll down a bit, there's a spot to enter or change a password for the entire project. Simply press Set Password and then Publish the project. If we enter a password here and try to visit any page that's been published, password. That's adding a password to the whole project or website. Finally, we have the password page itself. This design applies to any password protected page on your project. At the heart of it are two elements, the password input field and the button you press to submit. And what we'll do is we'll go over to the element settings. Why? Because we have different options depending on what's selected. When we select each of these elements, we have different settings we can modify. And with the parent element selected, we can preview and modify or style not only the default state, but the wrong password state too. And you can modify and style this page to your heart's desire. Maybe a text link which says, take me back home, or a text block that shows Kyle's passwords in plain text. So, password protected pages. We can add a password to a page. We can do the same to a folder, which password protects all pages inside that folder. As another option, we can do all this from the editor. And of course, we can customize and style the password protected page to fit our brand. And that's password protection.